In this video, I will discuss the post-operative management of a patient with a differentiated thyroid carcinoma. There are two main groups. I will start the discussion with a patient who, for whatever reason, has decided against total thyroidectomy. This group may include those who fall in the low-risk category, being females younger than 50, males younger than 40, with a small lesion that is well-differentiated, and who have no lymph node involvement. These patients cannot undergo the full extent of post-operative follow-up because thyroglobulin levels cannot be used. They undergo instead clinical, sonographic, and scintigraphic surveillance of the neck. Should a new tumor arise or if there's any recurrence, a completion thyroidectomy is advised and they fall within the first group of this algorithm that I will discuss shortly. It is difficult to monitor these patients for distant metastases, and periodic imaging, including whole body scintigraphy, may be done on a regular basis. If any concern arises due to symptoms such as bone pain, chest pain, chronic cough, etc., the patient should undergo a full workup for distant metastases. In a patient who has undergone a total thyroidectomy with ipsilateral compartment clearance for papillary thyroid carcinoma or Hürthle cell carcinoma, or completion thyroidectomy for follicular cell carcinoma, a period of 6 weeks is allowed to lapse. This allows for TSH levels to rise and make imaging more effective. A radioactive iodine or technetium scintigram and neck ultrasound is performed and thyroglobulin levels determined. In the vast majority of patients, thyroglobulin will not be detectable and imaging will show no or a small thyroid remnant and no recurrent disease. These patients have to decide on radioactive iodine ablation for the benefit of destroying any micrometastases and to make thyroglobulin follow-up accurate. A week later, a whole body scintigram is performed. Again, the vast majority will be negative and they can be followed up 6 monthly and then yearly with clinical examination, ultrasound of the neck, thyroglobulin levels, together with a whole body scintigram. It must be remembered to commence thyroxine after the whole body scan, as these patients will by now be suffering from effects of hypothyroidism. Recombinant TSH, if available, may be added to scintigraphic evaluation of any kind. TSH increases iodine uptake and may increase the sensitivity of scintigraphy in this way. It can also be used when a patient is on thyroxine suppression and therefore have low TSH levels that will make scintigraphy less useful. Thyroxine is given and monitored to keep the TSH level below normal, but not so as to cause hyperthyroidism. Some malignant cells may be stimulated by TSH and hence the suppressive thyroxine dose. If the whole body scan is positive or any future thyroglobulin or scintigram shows metastases or a recurrence, a full workup and management is required. In a few cases, thyroglobulin may not be detected, but there seems to be residual or very early recurrent disease. Fine needle aspiration cytology is performed on this tissue, and if shown to be malignant, there is a choice between radioactive iodine ablation and surgery, each with their resultant follow-up as shown. If negative, this remnant tissue can be surgically removed or ablated with radioactive iodine. In another scenario, thyroglobulin may be detected, and there is the possibility of retained or recurrent disease. Fine needle aspiration cytological evaluation is performed, and if positive, the algorithm follows that of the previous scenario. If negative, a search for distant metastases should be included, and the residual tissue managed by ablation or resection. If there is no sign of residual thyroid or disease or very early recurrent disease, but thyroglobulin is detected, a full workup for distant metastases should follow. It is important to remember the limitations of the studies that are performed. Not all tumors will produce thyroglobulin, and this leads to false negatives. Some people have antibodies against thyroglobulin. Furthermore, tumors and metastases may de-differentiate and not take up scintigraphic tracer. The patient must be made aware of these limitations, and at any stage, in the face of negative tests, if clinical concern arises, other forms of investigation such as CT, MRI, and PET should be utilized.